God's story. Gideon. So part of God's story is about a man named Gideon, and it begins like this. Israel, God's special family, had turned against the one real God and worshipped idols. They had forgotten how God had loved and cared for them and needed a reminder that he was the one in charge. So God took away the Israelites' farms for 7 long years. Whenever the Israelites planted crops, God would let another nation called the Midianites sweep through and camp on Israel's land, ruining everything that was growing there. But even though his own family had forgotten him, God still loved them deeply. So, at the end of the 7 years, God appeared to a young Israelite named Gideon. God said he was going to free the Israelites with Gideon's help. Gideon, however, wasn't so sure, so he asked God to prove himself by performing a series of miracles. Gideon said, "If the fleece is wet with dew in the morning but the ground is dry, then I will know that you're going to help me rescue Israel as you promised." That's what happened. Just to be sure, the next night, Gideon asked God to do the opposite, make the fleece dry and make the ground wet. And God did it. Next, he even sent a sign through an angel. Gideon was finally convinced that God was in his corner, so he called together an army to fight against the Midianites. Now, normally, having lots of people is a good thing when you're about to battle. But like I said, God does things a bit differently. He told Gideon that the Israelites had too many soldiers. If they won now, God knew the Israelites would say it was because of their own strength and brag about it. So, God wanted Gideon to have a smaller army. Gideon was nervous, but he did as God asked, which is always a good idea, by the way. He told his men that if they were afraid, they could return home. With that, 22,000 soldiers left, leaving Gideon with about 10,000. For you math whizzes, that's 2/3 of his army just poof, gone. Even after all that, the army was still too big. So God told Gideon to take the soldiers down to the water to drink, and then send home the soldiers who drank out of the stream like dogs. Again, Gideon did what God asked and was now left with only 300 soldiers. God knew Gideon was probably worried, so he told him to sneak down to the enemy camp where Gideon heard soldiers talking about a crazy dream where a loaf of bread rolled into the Midianite camp and over their tent. One soldier said that could only mean that Gideon would triumph over them. Gideon returned to his own camp confident that he would win the battle. He divided his men into 3 groups and gave them each a trumpet and a jar with a torch inside. Not usually what you bring to a fight, but God had a plan. Gideon's army reached the edge of the Midianite camp and then went into action. They blew their trumpets, smashed their jars, and shouted, "A sword for the Lord and for Gideon!" And don't forget, they did all of this without a single weapon in their hands. Terrified, the Midianites fled, accidentally attacking each other as they went. In fact, they ran so far from the battlefield that other Israelites were able to capture and defeat the leaders of the Midianites. With the enemy leaders gone and their army running away, God had saved Israel, just like he said he would. And that's the story of Gideon. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Israel turned away from God. God reminded them he was in charge. God said he would save Israel. He would use Gideon. God performed miracles for Gideon. Gideon gathered an army. God made it smaller. Much smaller. Soldiers had a dream. Gideon's army surprised their enemies. The Midianites ran away. God used Gideon to save Israel. And that's a part of God's story.
Hey everyone, Field Agents Trey and Grant.
Oh, hey guys.
And Harper, who's around here somewhere, and we're ready to bust some fears.
See, it looks like the fear we're busting today is stage fright. Ugh, getting up in front of people is awful. Everyone looking at you, all sweaty, knees weak, kind of dry mouth.
Oh, I bet I know who this is.
Hi, guys!
Hi, Spencer.
What are you guys up to today? Busting those fears? Or is it more like getting busted?
Okay, Spencer, we're actually trying to bust the fear of stage fright.
Stage fright? That's the worst! You're out there on your own, with no one to help! just you and the world?
I'm gonna have to side with Spencer on that one.
Grant, we've gotta figure this out. How do we bust the fear of getting on stage?
Well, isn't that Harper's expertise? She loves the stage. She's always singing and dancing. So
Spence, that's it. Harper, thanks for calling. We gotta go. Bye.
Okay, so she's gotta be around here somewhere. So on the count of three. One, two, three.
Harper!
I'm already on it, guys. Time to act it out.
God's people were living in Israel, but they were not obeying him at all. And now they were in trouble. A group of people who lived nearby, called the Midianites, were stealing their food. Because they were afraid of the Midianites, God's people had fear and hid from them. Finally, they realized they needed to ask God for help.
God, help us, please.
So God sent an angel to a man named Gideon, and the angel said,
God wants to help you get the Midianites out of Israel.
At first, Gideon was scared too, but God gave him signs that helped Gideon know that God would help him. So he obeyed God and gathered men who were willing to fight the Midianites. When God saw the number of men who were willing to fight, he told Gideon there were too many. So Gideon sent home all of the men who were afraid. Again, God saw the number of people and had Gideon send even more home. This had to make Gideon feel pretty scared.
How am I supposed to fight the Midianite army with only this many men?
God helped Gideon and told him what to do next. Gideon gave each person a jar, a torch, and a trumpet.
Here you go, take this. This one too, and take this while we're at it.
The men circled the Midianite camp, and when it became dark, Gideon signaled for his men to light their torches, break the jars, and blow their trumpets while shouting. The Midianites saw the lights and heard the loud noises and were so afraid that they ran away. Just like God helped Gideon and his people, he also promises to help us.
And knowing that God will help you is the best way to bust the fear of stage fright. I mean, check out Grant. He did such a great job acting.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't so bad. Knowing it on alone makes a big difference.
Sounds like we figured out that this fear of stage fright is...
busted!
Where's the spider?
Defender, provider, God, you are my I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that He is with me every day. He's by my side, He hears me when I pray. Jesus, I trust in